Hi guys, welcome back to another episode of Reviews and Previews. We're back again on a Friday night, Friday evening, doing another video, and as you can see there, Newcastle playing in a bit, so we better get this video done. Hooray! So, yeah, I guess we should get straight into it. Let's look at the results from last week. It was another poor week in terms of results for my teams. So, Newcastle 0, Chelsea 2. Go for the results as always. Newcastle 0, Chelsea 2. Poor game from Newcastle. We'll go on to that. Review it. Yeah, that's the right one, isn't it? Aston Villa 1, Brighton 2, Tottenham 2, Man City 0. Are Tottenham title contenders? I hope not. Please, no. It's alright. They'll bottle it anyway. It doesn't matter. Man United 1, West Brom 1. Penalties in that game, it's just ridiculous. VAR, I think. I don't know what's going on with it anymore. Fulham 2, Everton 3, that was a good game. Sheffield United 0, West Ham 1. Sheffield United still at the bottom of the table, they're struggling quite a lot. Leeds 0, Arsenal, it was a pretty good game, there's just no goals. Arsenal got, we'll go into that one as well, obviously. Liverpool 3, Leicester 0. I've said that Leicester were title contenders this year. I might want to retract that statement if I could. Burnley won, Crystal Palace now, Wolves won, Southampton won. So yeah, let's get into it. Newcastle first. Oh golly gosh, Jesus. Fernandes own goal and then Abraham in the second half. Yeah, it was routine for Chelsea. Newcastle were just poor. No Callum Wilson was a bit of a problem. And then we just didn't do enough any time, sort of time in the game to do anything that's really good. So, yeah, it's pretty poor from us overall. We just sat back and just defended. We didn't even try. And when we tried, we failed. So, yeah, it was just very poor and it's very disappointing. As I've said before, I think we've been playing absolutely horribly this season, even though we've done quite well to get points. So, I think we've been doing quite well to get those points. So, yeah, I don't know. We've got another tricky game tonight, which we'll preview in a minute. So, yeah, hopefully we get back on form, but I'm not sure. It's looking pretty sad at the minute. It's a sad time because we're just sort of struggling to do anything of note. Not making too many chances. I had eight shots, one on target. Yeah, that's just poor, though, isn't it? We're having 30% possession. I want to know it's hard against Chelsea, but they're still pretty poor. So, yeah, I don't know what to say else about it. It was just a really poor performance. I didn't really expect much. Hey, and I said the score right, I think, last week. I said 2-0 Chelsea, so yeah, there we go. Anyway, let's move on quickly to Arsenal. And the major talking point in this game was the Nicolas Pepe red card for headbutting that Leeds player called Alioski, that was his name, who went down like a sack of spuds, as you would say. Literally touched him with his head, he's like, oh, like he's dying or something, and he just tapped him in the head. Poor from him, but poor from Pepe as well, because I don't know what he's thinking. He's just completely had a lapse in his judgment, obviously. Hey, you haven't heard that's the first time you've heard that on YouTube. Yeah, I don't know what he was thinking. He just decided to headbutt him for some reason. So that's him gone for 3 games. Lovely. And Saka and Willian got injured as well. So we've got no wingers. So, yeah. Oh, dear. It's a pretty bad game. I think it was like sort of quite even until that red card. And then Leeds obviously won and tried to go and win it. We had a chance of the break right at the end with Saka and he missed. That would have been lovely if that just got in. We'd have won. Imagine the scenes if we'd have won that. But then they hit the woodwork 3 times, which was very lucky. Hit the same post like 3 times, I think. So we were really lucky. Leeds probably deserved something a bit more out of the game. But there you go. You make your own luck, don't you? So yeah. I thought we were alright. Leno made some good saves. Possession stats 34. Oh my god, that's as bad as Arsenal. Jesus Christ. Kept Leeds out though. Kept them out. We looked a bit more solid defensively again, I thought, in that game. But I thought we were a bit up front again, just so lacklustre. I think last five games we've only scored 1 goal and it was a penalty against Man United. So yeah, that was pretty poor. Anyway, let's get into the predictions for this week. And we've got the Crystal Palace Newcastle game. Oh God, what do I go with this? No, no, let's go for it. Crystal Palace 0, Newcastle 0. Boring 0-0. Can't even watch the game on Amazon Prime. Fabulous. Don't know why they're airing games on Amazon. I think that's just ridiculous. Why do they need to get involved? We've got, there's like three or four different places you can watch football now. Why can't they just make it simple? Just make it like one or two. Like, please make it more simpler. I don't know. Brighton 1, Liverpool 2. Man City 2, Burnley 0. Everton 1, Leeds 1. West Brom 1, Sheffield United 0. Southampton 0, Man United 2. Chelsea 1, Tottenham 3. Again, Tottenham are in really good form. I'm really scared for them this season. I think if they imagine Tottenham winning the league, oh, don't even want to think about it as an Arsenal fan. That would just be pain. Complete pain. Arsenal 1, Wolves 1. Probably a draw out of that game. Leicester 2, Fulham 1. West Ham 2. Let's have a high scoring game. West Ham 2, Aston Villa 3. Let's have a Villa win in that game. So let's review the Newcastle and Arsenal games in more detail here. So we've got Crystal Palace and Newcastle. I never knew that. Never knew he managed Crystal Palace. Anyway, Zaha's out for Crystal Palace, which is very good, thank God. Yeah, so that's very good he's out, because I think they looked blunt. I was watching their game against Burnley. They looked very blunt up front. They didn't look like they were going to make many chances. But then so did Newcastle, so I think I'm going 0-0, so because I think it's going to be a very poor game. We've got Callum Wilson hopefully to come back. I really hope he comes back, because that'll be good for us, because we need a bit of a spark up front. I thought Joe Linton did all right up front last week. I don't know if that was a wrong judgment of mine, but I thought he did all right. Did something. He was better than most other players. I think St. Maximum is just poor at the minute. He's not doing much. He's not doing enough right. Yeah, we just didn't seem to. Oh, why am I so tired? Anyway, yeah, I think it'll be a boring game. I think Crystal Palace are more likely to win it, because probably got a bit more form than us. But then again, Newcastle could easily win it as well. So yeah, we'll have to see. Maybe. I don't think we've... What's the stats? I think... Yeah, I thought so. We haven't... I don't think we've ever won their last five, so we never win there. Yeah, so I don't think we'll be... I think we'll be lucky to win that game, to even get something out of it tonight. Yeah, but hopefully, maybe. You never know. Cross your fingers and hope. Cross your fingers and hope. Let's hope. Come on. Anyway, on to Arsenal Wolves. Oh, yeah, so this is a big game. Ooh, you got a dead leg, that's all right then. Yeah, it's all right. Yeah, Saka's back in then, that's pretty good. Pepe's out, obviously. Willian Partey, that's not good. Yeah, Wolves are a tough team. They're very defensively resolute, but they're not the high... A bit like us, they defend quite well, but they don't score many goals. I think this will be a draw as well. I just don't think we're on form at the minute. At home, last... two or three games we've been poor. We lost to Villa and Leicester most recently at home, so that's been pretty poor from us. Anyway, I think Arsenal's only, yeah, as I said, I'm coming up to 500 minutes without a goal in open play. Yeah, so let's see. I'm not really talkative this episode. I'm not really sure what to say. It's a bit depressing, to be honest. My team's a minute. It's just a bit sad to watch them, because there's nothing, no goals, no wins. Oh, it's just horrible to watch, really. But Arsenal, I think they've got to come into this game with a bit more confidence, because I didn't think they looked too confident against Leeds. I just thought, well, we don't want to lose this game, but they didn't really ever go for the win. They just never really went for it, you know. I think Wolves will be a hard team to play against at home. They're very hard to beat. They always come good in the second half, obviously. And yeah. Also, Arsenal were playing Europa League last night, where we won. So that was good. And we're through to the last 32 now. So that's good. We've got that out of the way. We play some of the youngsters now. So that's good. I mean, I think we'll struggle. But I think... I'm not sure what's going to happen this game. We'll either win... I think we might win, but I'm not sure. I'm going to give a draw, because I just doubt us with our scoring ability. Maybe it'll come better after the Europa League, after we score some goals, where we rested loads of our players anyway. So, yeah. Hopefully we do something well. And let's round up this video, going to the top scorers, as we like to do. Calvert-Lewin on top, Son, Vardy, Salah, Kane, Bamford, top five, or six, one, two, there's six players there. Fernandes, Callum Wilson and Watkins are on six, and there's quite a few down there. No Arsenal players to be seen, except for Lacazette right at the bottom. Lovely. There, onto the table. Both my teams in the bottom half, 12th and 15th. Oh, gosh. Oh, God. I'm not sure what's going on. We're just really struggling. Sheffield United, West Brom, Fulham and Burnley. Burnley recently won, so maybe get them back in form, but they all look like they're in trouble already. Yeah, but then Tottenham, Liverpool and Chelsea, those look like the main three at the minute. And Man City are really struggling, even behind Arsenal. That tells you something. Jesus. When you're below Arsenal in the table, you know you're struggling. Oh, yeah. But that's probably going to wrap it up for this week, guys. I hope you've enjoyed, and yeah. I guess I'll see you next time, next Friday. We've been making some good videos recently. We're having a good schedule. I've not been uploading Minecraft recently. I've just not played it a lot. I'm a bit off Minecraft at the minute. Not too fussed on it. Yeah, so yeah. Anyway, guys, that's going to wrap it up for this week's video. I'll see you in the next one. See ya. Bye. Bye. Bye.